Children, back to exercise 16.2. Now we'll start with question number 11. They have already given you the figure for question number 11. Question number 10. It's given that it's a parallelogram and the diagonals AC and BD, they are intersecting each other at point O. We have to prove that OE and OF, they are equal. To prove that OE and OF are equal, I'm going to take the two triangles, that is AOE and FOC or COF, and I'm going to prove the congruency of these two triangles. And once the congruency is proved, these two sides will be equal by CP, CT. So, given it's a parallelogram ABCD, we have to prove OE is equal to OF. These are the two triangles we are taking. And in these two triangles, that's triangle AOE and COF, angle 1 is equal to angle 2. That's alternate angles. And angle 3 is equal to angle 4. These are also alternate angles. In place of 1 and 2, you can also write angle EAO and FCO. Angle AEO and angle CFO, these are alternate angles. And OA and OC, they are equal because diagonals of a parallelogram, they bisect each other. So we all know that OA and OC are equal. Now two angles are equal and one side is equal. So by AAS, your triangles are congruent. And if triangles are congruent, your two sides OE and OF, they are equal by CPCT. And the full form for CPCT is corresponding parts of the congruent triangles. Number 11 is your homework. This is exactly like your page 194, theorem number 3. You can see it from there. Now moving on to question number 12. The figure is already given to us in question number 12. And it is said that E and F, these are the points of the trisection of the diagonal AC. Trisection means like this diagonal is being cut in three equal parts. So AE, EF and FC, they are equal. Now what we have to do, we have to prove that DE is parallel to BF or FB. So we have to prove the parallelism of these two sides. Before we prove the parallelism, we have to keep in mind that the conditions required for proving the lines parallel are, if you have alternate angles equal, now these are alternate angles, if you can prove alternate angles equal, then also your sides are parallel. If you prove your corresponding angles are equal, now these are corresponding angles, take any two corresponding angles equal, then also your lines are parallel. And if you prove that your co-integrated angles are supplementary, now when we say supplementary, it means the sum is 180 degrees, then also we can prove the parallelism of two straight lines. Starting with the given part, parallelogram, and whatever information is given to you, write that. You have to prove that DE and BF, they are equal. Starting with the proof part, in triangle ADE and triangle BCF, now that's the figure. So first of all, your AD and your BC, it's equal because these are the opposite sides of the parallelogram. Angle DAE and angle BCF. Now this and this angle, they are also equal. These are alternate angles. If you don't want to take the complete name, you can mark them as angle 1 and angle 2. Then AE and CF are equal. This is AE and CF equal because these are the parts of the trisection. So by SAS, your two triangles are congruent. And if two triangles are congruent, these angles are equal by CP, CT. Now we can say that DE is parallel to BF. Now as alternate angles are equal, the lines are parallel. As one pair of alternate angles are equal, the lines are parallel. Hence your question is proved. Question number 13. You have to prove that your parallelogram is a rectangle if the diagonals are of equal length. The figure is not given. We'll draw one parallelogram naming it as ABCD. And we all know that AB and CD are equal because opposite sides are equal. Now we are going to, this is given, parallelogram ABCD in which your AC and BD are equal because diagonals are equal. It's already given to us in the question. We have to prove that this parallelogram is a rectangle. And remember, if you have to prove that your given parallelogram is a rectangle, you have to prove each angle equal to 90 degrees. So here I'm going to split the parallelogram in the lower part of the parallelogram in two triangles. That is triangle ABD and triangle ABC. And I'm going to prove the congruency of these two triangles. And after that, I'll prove angle A and angle B equal by CPCT property. So in triangle ABD and BAC, AD is equal to BC, opposite sides of parallelogram, AB and AB common. BD is equal to AC, that because the diagonals are equal. So by triple S, your triangles are congruent. And if triangles are congruent, your angles, that's A and B, they are equal by CPCT property. We also know that your angle A and angle B is equal to 180 degrees. These are co-interior angles. So you either take them as X and X or you can take them as A and A, and you get the value of A as 90 degrees. Now if A is 90, B is also 90 degrees. And if A is 90, C is 90 because opposite angles are equal. Now B is 90, D is also 90 because opposite angles are equal. So here your angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D each angle is 90 degrees, so the given parallelogram is a rectangle. Hence, the question is proved. Question number 14, parallelogram name is PQRS, T is the midpoint of PQ and U is the midpoint of SR. You have to prove that the center part, that is PTRU, that's also a parallelogram. Now, again, we draw a figure, we join the lines. This is the given part, this is the to prove part, and construction means we are joining PU and TR or RT. Now we have to prove that the center portion is a parallelogram. Now T is the midpoint of PQ, so we can say that PT and TQ are equal. U is the midpoint of SR, so we can say that SU and UR are equal. Now also we also know that PQ is equal to SR because these are the opposite sides of the parallelogram and they are equal. And PQ is parallel to SR because opposite sides of parallelogram are parallel also. So we get to know that PT is equal to TQ is equal to SU is equal to UR. Now taking the center part, that's a quadrilateral PTRU. PT and UR equal, that's proved above. PQ and SR equal, that's the opposite sides of the parallelogram. And PT is parallel to QR because opposite the parts of the parallel line. These are the parts, UR sorry, these are the parts of the parallel line. So as one pair of opposite sides of quadrilateral, they are equal also and parallel also. The given quadrilateral, which is PTRU, is a parallelogram. Hence, the question is proved. Number 15 is your homework. It's exactly like question number 14. Now, let's move on to question number 16. This is the figure given to you for question 16. You have to find angle ODA, ODA, that is this angle, and angle OCD, that is this angle. So, here, this given figure is a rectangle. And diagonals are intersecting each other at point O, and this angle is given to us as 100 degrees. So we'll start with the solution. First of all, in your triangle AOB, that this center triangle, this angle and this angle, that is angle OAB and angle OBC, are equal. Why they are equal? Because we know that the diagonals bisect each other, and as per that property, these two sides are equal. And if these two sides are equal, this triangle will become an isosceles triangle. And the base angles are equal in isosceles triangle. So these are equal because these are angles opposite to equal sides. We take them as x and x, then use angle sum property. The value of x we get as 40 degrees. So your angle OAB and angle OBA comes as 40 degrees. Now you take your triangle ABD, and in your triangle ABD, your DAB angle is 90 degrees. Because each angle of rectangle is 90 degrees only. Now ABD, that is 40 degrees, or you can say it's OBA, that's 40 degrees shown above. We've already calculated it. Now use your angle sum property for the triangle, and you get angle ODA using, see, this triangle we have taken, this is 40, this is 90, and then use angle sum property and you'll get this angle, which is angle ODA as 50 degrees. And finally, to find angle OCD, it's equal to angle OAB, angle OAB, because this angle and this angle, these are alternate angles. So what that angle is 40 degrees, so angle OCD is also equal to 40 degrees. Now this is the figure given for question number 70. It's a rhombus, and we have to prove that AB square plus BC square plus CD square plus DA square is equal to 4 times OA square and OB square. Now as per the properties of a rhombus, diagonals bisect at right angles. So what we are going to do, we'll be taking each angle separately and using the Pythagoras theorem for that. Now this is the figure, splitting it into 4 triangles. Now taking first triangle, that is triangle AOB, and using Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem states that hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. This is marked as equation 1. Same thing, do it for the second triangle. Again use Pythagoras theorem. You'll get BC square is equal to OB square plus OC square. Then use for the third triangle, that is COD. Again use Pythagoras theorem, you will get CD square is equal to OC square plus OD square. And then use it for the last triangle and you will get DA square is equal to OD square plus OA square. Now these are 4 equations, adding all the 4 equations. Now when you are adding the equations, LHS is added to LHS and the right side is added to the right side. Now we also know that OA and OC are equal because diagonals bisect each other. And OB and OD are equal because diagonals of rhombus bisect each other. So what we are going to do, wherever there is OC, we'll write OA. And wherever there is OD, we'll be writing OB. Now, replacing them, and you'll get 2 times OA square, 2 times OB square, 2 times OA square, and 2 times OB square. Now, OA square is 2 and 2, that is 4 times. OB square is 2 and 2, that is 4 times. Taking 4 common, and we'll get AB square plus BC square plus CD square plus DA square is equal to 4 times OA square plus OB square. Hence, the question is proof. So, with this, we finish chapter 16, which is quadrilaterals. Thank you.